what is managerial economics, and the managerial decision problems. So first you will learn about what is economics. The economics is nothing but the study of human activity. The study of human activity as an individual or as a group or in the form of society. The society. Now, the economics is concerned with the human problems, economic problems. The economic problem is nothing but wants. The economic problem is nothing but what is an individual study? The individual study is nothing but an individual activity. The individual activity is nothing but satisfying wants. The wants in the form of food, clothing, and shelter. Food, clothing, and shelter. So, the managerial economics is divided into two disciplines, is studied in two different disciplines, that is management and economics. The management is nothing but is the study of planning, organizing, directing, controlling, and coordinating. Okay? Now, economics is the study of individual activity as well as national activity. Individual as well as national study. What it studies about is nothing but satisfying wants. Satisfying wants. Is it wants are limited or unlimited? Obvious wants are unlimited. So, in the process of satisfying the wants, we need to have the resources. Is it the resources are limited or unlimited? Limited or unlimited? Limited resources. So, the acquisition and deploying the resources is called as managerial economics. Is called as managerial economics. So, in 18th century, father of economics, who is father of economics is nothing but Adam Smith. Adam Smith is father of economics related to 18th century, defined economics as the study of nature and uses of national wealth. Adam Smith defines economics as the study of nature and uses of national wealth. Wealth, why they defined as wealth? Because of earning money and spending this money. Earning money, spending this money is a contribution of Adam Smith. Is a contribution of Adam Smith. Now, later, another economist thought, economics is not only wealth, but also welfare. Who gave this contribution? Alfred Marshall, 19th century. And he defines economics as the study of man's how he defines the study of man's action in terms of how he gets income and how he uses it. How he gets income and how he uses it is according to whom? Alfred Marshall. Okay, these two contributions, 18th century and 19th century, are the two economists contributed, and the third economist, Lionel Robbins, who defines economics as the science of ends and scarce means of resources. What he defines? Ends and scarce means of resources means the relationship between wants, the relationship between the needs and the wants satisfied. The wants are limited, but the resources are limited. The wants are unlimited, but the resources are limited. In the process of this, he defines, is it, now what about the resources? Okay, so this is about economics. Is it clear for you? Can I continue with managerial economics? Okay. So this is about managerial economics. And next, sorry, economics. And now, managerial economics. So the managerial economics helps in decision making, forward planning, with the help of application of economic theory.
Without any